Now we're ready to look at the boundary conditions. In the Setup menu, go to Boundary Conditions, and you'll see here how we have all of our named selections. So let's start at the very top. Far side, we're going to set this, rather than type wall, it's going to be pressure far field. And you can see now how we can enter all of the boundary conditions that were specified at the beginning of this problem. So for our gauge pressure in PSI, we're going to enter 45.829. Our Mach number is 0.8395. And we're at a 3.06 degree angle of attack. So we're going to change our components of the flow direction. Our X component is 0.9986, and our Y component is 0.0534. The last thing that we need to change is in the thermal tab. Our temperature in Rankine is 460 degrees Rankine. So select OK. Now our next boundary condition will be at the inlet. So instead of a velocity inlet, it's also a pressure far field. So we're also going to specify the exact same boundary conditions as before. So for the pressure, let's enter our 45.829 PSI, Mach number 0.8395, X component, and Y component. And don't forget the temperature, 460 degrees Rankine. So our near side is our symmetry plane. So instead of being a wall, we're going to set this to be type symmetry. Hit OK. And our outlet is not a pressure outlet, but pressure far field. So we're going to select the exact same boundary conditions here as before. So 45.829 PSI, Mach number is 0.8395, and our components of flow direction are also the same here. And I'll finally change the temperature there. And okay. So the wing surface and the wing tip are both of type wall, and this is essentially setting the velocity at this area to be zero. We need to check our operating condition. So if you can see here, our operating pressure is set to be 14 psi. This is not what we want because the pressure that we specified in our boundary conditions at the pressure far field was the absolute pressure. So we are just going to set this operating pressure to be zero. Once you've done that, hit OK. And with that, we are finished with the boundary conditions.